We kind of got in a habit for a while of sitting in meetings all day, talking about things and arguing whether or not things were possible and not possible. And now with the MakerBots and being able to prototype some of these new hardware product designs in a day, we can, you know, just whip something up. And basically these meetings have gone from a lot of arguing to just like, okay, cool idea, make it. I'm Ian Bernstein, and I'm the co-founder and CTO at Orbotix. We are trying to change the way kids play games, interact with their toys, by creating this sort of new category of smart toy, connected toys. The initial idea behind our company was, I was working at a robotics company one night, and I was, you know, playing with my smartphone, and I thought, how cool would it be if I could control these robots with my phone? And back in 2009, nobody was doing it. You know, we'd come up with like hundreds of different ideas, and I was like, we just need something simple. My co-founder Adam was like, well, what about a marble? And I was like, well, what about a robot ball? Because I'd actually built one when I was 14, this little simple robot ball, so that's what I thought back to. The culture at Orbotix is, you know, very much hacker and making, and we did a lot of stuff on the software side, but having that creativity on the hardware side, having the 3D printers in our office, was important, because I think doing this hacking and being able to quickly iterate on different thoughts you're having and creative ideas is important, you know, especially for us, obviously. It's one of our core values of our company and really like a requirement at our company. Sphero 2B is our new robot. It's a tube shape, and basically we just wanted to take our control system that's inside Sphero and just see if we can make just the craziest driving experience we can. So this thing goes like 10 miles an hour. You hit a little jump and you get about 3 feet of air. This is actually the very real first prototype of Sphero 2B. I made this myself on our MakerBot one night. And I called it the Joker because I printed it with sort of Joker colors, like you got the purple and the green. Nobody was like totally sold on the tube until this was created. And we sent out a little video of it, like 10 o'clock at night, our videographer just like pulled out his iPhone, and we hit a jump and we jumped over 4 Sphero boxes stacked on top of each other. When it's in the air, you can see it leveling itself using our gyros and accelerometers. Like as soon as it hits the ground, it just takes off in the direction you were controlling it. This is the more refined prototype of Sphero 2B that will be out this fall. The designs that we're coming out with now can be more advanced. When we started Orbotix, we were, you know, I was building all the Sphero prototypes with paper clips and brass and stuff like that. And you can only go so far with that, but having the MakerBot and being able to make more advanced parts, you know, we're doing bigger and better things now.